Hello to everyone. I am Dr. Alkesh Agarwal, and in this lecture, I'll mainly discuss what is an encoder, and then I'll discuss two specific cases of encoder, which are octal to binary encoder and priority encoder. These are some reference books that include a book Digital Design by M. Morris Menno and M. Distillery. Another book is Modern Digital Electronics, authored by R. P. Jain. So first of all, let us discuss what is an encoder. So encoder do not have a general design, but the design of encoder depends upon the requirement. So in this particular slide, we have discussed an encoder, which is converting the information in octal form into its binary equivalent. So you can see inputs are from D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, that is from decimal equivalent 0 to 7, that is in octal form. And then the output, we have a table depicting then the output in binary form, that is B0, B1, B2. So this here in this particular slide, this encoder is converting the octal information into its binary equivalent. So let us discuss how it works. So here you have to see, out of if you see each column and each row, in each column and each row only one cell is high, rest all other inputs are low. So for D0, first row, the intersection of first row and first column is high, whereas for D1, the intersection of second row and second column is high. For D2, the intersection of third row and third column is high. For D3, intersection of fourth row and fourth column is high. For D4, the intersection of fifth row and fifth column is high. For D5, the intersection of sixth row and sixth column is high. For D6, the intersection of seventh row and seventh column is high. And for D7, the intersection of eighth row and eighth column is high. So what is important is for this encoder to work properly. So in each row, only one input should be high. Rest all other inputs must be low. So here we see when D0 is high, we have binary output as 000, because the decimal 0 is represented as in binary as 000. Similarly, when D1 input is high, it is being encoded as in binary as 001, because 00001 is a binary equivalent value for decimal 1. Similarly, when D2 input is high, it is encoded as 010. Similarly, when D3 input is high, it is encoded as 011. When D4 input is high, it is encoded as 100. When D5 is high, it is encoded as 101. When D6 is high, it is encoded as 110, and when D7 is high, it is encoded as 111. So now you must have understood very easily how this encoder is working. So here you can see this diagonal values are high, rest all other values are zero. Now you can see depict this output Boolean functions. So you can see for B0, the high value corresponds to D1, then for D3, for D5, and for D7. So we have B0 is equal to D1 or D3 or D5 or D7. Similarly, B1 have high output values for D2, and this is high for D3, this value is high for D6, and this value is high for D7. So we have B1 is equal to D2 or D3 or D6 or D7. Similarly, B2 value is high for D4, for D5, for D6, and for D7. So B2 output is equal to D4 or D5 or D6 or D7. Now let us take another very important type of encoder, which is being termed as priority encoder. So you can see, though it is a very small table, but a lot of information is embedded into this table. So we have to focus on this table. Here we have inputs as D0, D1, D2, D3. Here you can see this less than arrow is being placed. Now they have some information contained within them. So we know, since the name is priority encoder, so here we have shown the priority. So D1 has priority greater than D0, D2 has priority greater than D1, and D3 has priority greater than D2, which means out of D0, D1, D2, D3, D3 has the highest priority and D0 has the lowest priority. So you can understand this with an example. Suppose in a computer system we are performing multitasking. Suppose we are listening to music, we are doing some work on Windows, or and we are some also doing work with paintbrush, or we are doing some programming. But the moment you just tab control plus alt plus delete, so your computer moves on into the shut off mode. So which means that pressing control plus alt plus delete has the highest priority over other tasks that we are performing. Similarly here, D3, so you can see from this, then when you just reverse, you just see from this, when D3 is 1, because D3 has the highest priority, so when D3 is 1, it doesn't matter what is the value of D0, D1, D2, because we have put don't care conditions. So when D3 is 1, irrespective of what is D0 or D1 or D2, because they are in don't care condition, the output will be encoded as 1, 1. And this is because D3 has the highest priority. So when D2 is 1 for this, when D2 is 1, so D3 should be 0. Because when D3 is 1, that case is covered in fourth row. But when D2 is 1, D3 has to be 0. But since D2 has the priority greater than D0 and D1, so when D2 is 1, what is important is D3 should be 0, but D0 and D1 can be any value. So we have put don't care condition. So what is important is D2, when D2 is 1, D3 should be 0, and D0, D1 can be any value. So in that case, binary, it will be encoded as 1, 0. Similarly, when D1 is 1, so we are giving priority to D1. So D2 should be must be 0 and D3 must be 0, but D0 can be any value. So we put a don't care condition that it can be 0, it can be 1. But if D1 is 1, so D2 and D3 must be 0, 0. So in that case, we get an encoded output as 0, 1. And when D0 is 1, in that case, because D0 has the least priority, for in that case, D1 and D2 and D3 must all be 0. So in that case, output will be encoded as 0, 0. So when D0 is 1, it will be, so we have four different conditions on priority basis. So when D0 is 1, D1, D2, D3 must be 0. It will be encoded as 0, 0, because decimal 0 is represented as 0, 0. So when D1 is 1, it will be encoded as binary 0, 1, but in that case, D0 can be any value 0 or 1, but D2 and D3 must be 0, 0. So when D2 is 1, it will be encoded as 1, 0 in binary, but for that, D3 must be 0, and D0 and D1 can be any values from 0, 0 to 1, 1. So that I'll elaborate in next slide. And for when D3 is 1, it will be encoded as 1, 1, but in that case, since D3 has the highest priority, D0, D1, D2 can be any value. So I hope this slide must be understood by all. Now let us elaborate the information in this truth table in this slide. So see, I have a very, in a very easy manner, I have elaborated the information. So here, let us discuss this information in this. So here, this information is don't care value 100. So we have don't care 100. Now how we have information which is hidden in this is of M4 and M12. How this don't care we can take a value 0 or 1. So in 1 we have 0 and another condition is 1. Rest all other information are fixed. So we have 0100 and 1100. So this 0100 corresponds to M4 and 1100 corresponds to M12. So in this row we have two min terms that are hidden, which is M4 and M12. Now let us take another look into this, where we have elaborated this information in this cross 10. So we have cross 10. So this 10 is fixed of D2 and D3. So this is fixed for all, but this don't care can be of different values. So we can have four different combinations: 00, 01, 10, and 11. So these don't care are being replaced with four combinations: 00, 01, 10, 11. Rest these two values are fixed. So now we have 0010, which is M2, 0110 as M6, 1010 as M14, and 1110 as M. So this is 1010 is M10 and 1110 is M14. Now let us take this last row, cross 1. So we have cross 1. So this D3 is fixed to 1, whereas we have 3 don't care condition. So we have 3 don't care condition, and they are being converted into 8 combination. So if you put these don't care conditions, so we have 8 combination from 000 to 111, because we have to put all the values, because this can have two values 01, this can have values as 01, or this can have value as 01. So with all these combination, we have 8 different configurations from 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. So if we see, the first is 0001 is M1, 0011 is M3, 0101 is M5, 0111 is M7, 1001 is M9, 1011 is M11, 1101 is M13, and 1111 is M15. So like this, we have the information that is hidden into this small table is being elaborated as M4, M12, M2, M6, M14, M10, and M1, M3, M5, M7, M9, M11, M13, and M15. So now we'll design two K maps. One is for B0, one is for B1. So now we can see for B0, the value is high for this cross 100. So that is B1 is high for M4 and M12. So B0 is high for M4 and M12. So we put 1 and 1 over here. And then it is also high for this last row, where we have these min terms 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. So we put 1 as 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. So we have 8 min terms. So now here you can see we have two groups of min terms. One is this small group of 4 min terms, one is a bigger group of 8 min terms. So from this group, what we obtain in reduced form as, we have to concentrate on these two rows, where D1 is fixed and D0 is changing. So we have D1, and from these two columns, we have D2 is fixed and D3 is changing. So D3 is eliminated. So what we get is D2 dash. So we have D1, D2 dash, and from this bigger group, D0 and D1 are being eliminated because they are changing from one level to another level, and what is fixed is D3. So we have this output as B0 is equal to D1 and D2 dash or D3. Now let us see B1. So B1 is high and high. So B1 is high for this cross 10, where we have 4 min terms M2, M6, M14, and M10. And we have this high value for these min terms: 1, M1, M3, M5, M7, M9, N11, M13, and M15. So we put all these values with M1, M5, M9, and M13, and we put 1 over these M3, M2, M3, M6, M7, M14, M15, M10. So we have one group. One, this group is common in both. So we have from, you can see from here, we have 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So we have 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. And then we have 2, 6, 40, 10, 14. So we have 2, 6, 10, 14. So like this, we have two groups of 8 minterms each from, since this is common. So for this, we get D3. And from this group, which is encircled with green, we get D2. because here d0 d1 are eliminated because their values are being changed, and what is fixed is d2. So like this we get two outputs. One is b1. For b1 we have d2 or d3, and for b0 we have d1 and d2 dash or d3. Thank you.